Keeping animals healthy is always a top priority for owners. So tonight on Rural America Live, we talk with the founder and owner of Total Feeds, Dr. Harry Anderson. And he is live with us now from our studios in Fort Worth, Texas. We are also joined by Punk Carter. It's great to have both of you here.
Thank you. Great to be here again. I always love this.
Of course, we're talking Total Feeds. So let's start by looking at the wheel and all the products that you offer.
Yes, ma'am. I love to show that product wheel because we have enlarged it to cover just about every product we have, every animal we have. Mm-hmm. We have Total People Plus, which is the last product we made. But Total Feeds is Total Equine LNSE, Total Goat, Total Bird, Total Lamb, Total Deer, Total Canine. I guess I covered that one. But we have something for everybody is the bottom line.
Yeah, that's great. We'll be talking about a lot of those products more in detail. Of course, everyone can go to totalfeeds.com for more information. And you give out your personal cell phone number if they have any questions, comments, testimonies they want to share. Let's get into talking to Punk Carter. He's a trainer of the stars.
Punk has been totally equine feeder now for, I think, 5 years.
A little over five. I was just thinking because my stud's been on all of his life.
Since yeah, but you, first of all, before we get into Punk Carter, there's a little thing I like to always share at this time of the year, Punk, with the horse owners out there, is summertime heat stress. You've seen it over your lifetime,
I'm sure. Yeah, I've seen it with the broodmares. I've seen it with the riding horses. I've seen it with all of it. And heat is a really big factor with a horse, the way he thinks, I think, too.
You bet.
You can overheat him. If you overheat him, he loses concentration pretty bad.
And not only that, when you do that, you have the chance of compaction colic from lack of water intake. I wanted to just tell the folks out there that, and I think you stated this earlier, that you don't have the problem of heat overload with Total Equine. Is that true?
No, we haven't. And you know, you brought it up, and I didn't even thought about it, to be honest with you, because it don't happen. We, like I said, we went to South Texas the other day, and it's hot down there, and we had some three-year-olds pulling, dragging calves on, and we didn't see anything go wrong.
So your horses drink water on the road,
Yeah. You don't have any problem with them drinking the water, and that's a really big factor, because a lot of horses won't drink certain, they quit drinking on the road, like you said.
That's right. Yeah. Well, folks, one thing I want to leave with you today is that you don't have to have those problems with hot weather colics and with the compaction colic from not drinking. If nothing else, if you're feeding Total Equine, and if you aren't, you should, you need to just take a big handful of Total Equine, drop it in the water bucket, and they'll just drink it all down to get at that Total Equine. Isn't that sick, slick?
Yeah.
So simple. Well, Punk, tell us a little bit about Punk Carter. How long you been training horses? Can you remember that long?
No. I really started a training program probably after we got married. We've been married 55 years today, so.
Congratulations.
Yeah,
but,
happy anniversary.
All my life, but it's been a great, the best part about my deal, I get to ride all kinds of horses.
Well, I bet.
I just don't train cutting horses. Cutting horses has been a big factor of our life because it's a good way to make a living. But we flew with roping horses, barrel horses. I've got to ride every kind of horse. I got to show ravens in the cuttings and stuff like that. And that's it's.
So you take in horses constantly with people coming to you.
And you say that you take in horses constantly. The best thing I've learned about Total Equine, people say, well, I feed this, I feed that. I said, I feed Total Equine, they'll start it right then, and I don't have to worry about changing the diet on it. They're going to eat it,
okay.
And they're not going to, colic on it, they're not going to founder on it. It makes it so much simpler.
Oh, yeah. Well, Punk, I think you have a few kind of good little stories of successes and some visuals that I'd like people to see. Like, you have a stud horse that looks pretty shiny.
All winter long, this horse, we've never put a blanket on him.
Yeah?
And he looks like, this is a three-year-old horse here.
Okay.
He's half thoroughbred.
Okay.
And I'm telling you, everybody that rides him said, this is the best mounted horse I've ever seen. He's been on it all of his life.
Okay.
He's just a blessing to ride. He's an easiest horse to get along with. And being a half thoroughbred, you have, they could get a little hot, sure,
but
he doesn't.
High speed, yeah. And then you have a couple of three-year-olds that you wanted to show.
We raised some babies. They've been on it all their life, ever since we weaned them. With these two, we took to South Texas and drug calves on. they just look there. I mean, they had never had a blanket on.
Well, dragging calves on a three-year-old, that sometimes you have to be a little careful, right?
We've been roping on these since they were two-year-olds.
Okay.
Yes, I mean, their minds have just been so good. I mean, I don't.
Do you feel that they mature a little more rapidly than what you were used to in the past?
I would say, I don't know. It's maturity plus, like you said, the they don't get hot, so they don't get as stirred, you might say.
Do you feel that makes them a little easier to train as young horses?
Of course, yeah.
They focus with you and pay attention?
Focus is a good term.
Okay. Yeah. Well, that's great. And then you have some customer horses that mm-hmm. owned.
Yes.
Yeah, I think you want to talk about, like Ashley Jent's horse.
Yes, she bought a mare and down by Beaumont, Texas. Just been on hay all her life. You know, round bale of hay, coastal hay. This is when she first got her, the bottom pitcher, and this was like, and she told you or me, what, 7 or 8 weeks later?
Right.
Because I said, you know, put her on total equine. And she'd never been bred before. We bred her this year, the first time she caught. First round, so.
Well, I'm glad she has some good markings there that we can tell that the same horse.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that amazing, though?
They might not believe you.
No. I mean, my horse is in the barn. I'm kind of old school. I don't like blankets. I don't like this.
I don't either. I agree.
But all my horses all winter long, their hair is great.
Yeah.
Great.
It doesn't get that big, bushy, shaggy.
Nope.
Yeah.
My stud, you'll see him in a minute. We rope on him. We cut on him.
Yeah.
He's probably everybody says, I've never been around a stud so good-minded.
Yeah.
We took him to a cutting last week, and took him to the stud farm 2 days before that, and you wouldn't even know he was a stud in the deal. It's amazing.
Yeah, right. Well, you know, I don't know if we have a picture of your stud.
But he shines. Everybody said he looked like a shiny penny or something.
Yeah.
He's a sorrel horse.
Well, I love to hear this, about that hair coat.
Yeah.
But you have a little story about Powder.
Mm-hmm. He belonged to
Tell us about Powder.
Well, I was looking for a horse for a customer of mine, and my brother had his wife had this horse, and they weren't doing that much with him. It just turned out, and you can see his hair, it was long, and that was Powder, you know, he was taken care of, but his hair was long in the winter time and we put him on. I told him, you know, they bought him, friend, one of our customers bought him, Jeff, and they put him on total equine. I said, you'd put him on, and this was like less than 2 months. Look at his hair now. I mean, he's shined like a. They took him to a cutting this weekend.
Yeah.
Won the cutting on him.
Well, great.
Yeah.
It's always fun to win.
Yeah, it was great.
And that's great. And you've had a lot of experience with Total Equine, you know, and so that's pretty same. But I've been asking you to try a new product called Equine 15. Now, Equine 15 is kind of an interesting thing, and I've talked about this before. It comes in little canisters. You buy a canister for one horse for 1 month. It's 150 grams in here, and you feed 5 grams a day. So that's, if you do the math, that's 30 days. Mm-hmm. And but some of the benefits that we've seen are quite outstanding, and we're going to talk about a couple here. But some of the things that we've had people tell us about, all the way from controlling EPM to reducing navicular problems and heaves. We get a lot of calls about people that have had chronic coughs or heaves in the horses, and they go away real easy. But that joint damage and hock inflammation and laminitis symptoms, those are all kind of in a category of chronic pain.
Mm-hmm.
They're telling us how they go away. The soreness in the hocks, and reduced hives. We had one on the last show about reduced hives. But a couple of ones that are not, that one at the bottom, suspensory ligament improvement. I have a farrier that says it absolutely helped recover some horses from suspensory ligament problems, which is supposed to be a death penalty, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. And the one that I don't have on here that I just got the other day was a horse that had shivers and now doesn't have shivers anymore after 30 days on this. But Punk, I want you to tell a little bit about a horse called Shadow.
Yes. I get emotional.
That's all right.
My brother trained him.
Okay.
And he called me one day and said, I got Shadow. They just want to kind of retire him, semi-retire him. He'd be a good horse for a lesson horse.
Okay.
So we took him and That's him.
Okay.
But he was doing great, and he got where he didn't want to cut like he used to, you know. He just didn't act like he felt good.
Okay.
Blah, blah.
Just off.
Yeah,
huh?
Off. And the lady, Mary Ann and Jeff, who bought Powder, I said, why don't y'all take, Mary Ann loves him because that was her first horse to cut on, you know. I said, take him over and keep him and just, you know, give Powder a buddy. So I said, just bring him back and you can do your lessons on him. But he just didn't act like he wanted to cut like he wanted to, you know. And she said, Punk, I'm having trouble picking up his left hind foot.
Okay.
I said, oh my gosh, maybe we ought to get him injected. And you sent me the product.
Yeah.
I said, let's try this first. I you showed me all the benefits to it. She brought him back over, and he was like a different horse, like he just turned the switch, you know. I mean, he was back to his old self, I mean, just trancing around there. And he really moves his head when he cuts. He's real quick and fast. So.
You can pick his foot up?
Pick his foot up. I don't see any reason why you'd ever have to inject him now. I mean, he's back to normal. We took him to the cutting. The husband was first, and she was second on Shadow. Shadow looked like a little machine out there cutting. He was just as happy as he could be, you know.
Well, that's great.
Oh, yeah.
And you and I talked to a lady on the phone with you yesterday,
Jennifer Hinton.
That had a story. Tell me about her.
She has an old gelding that was an old cutting horse, and her little girl runs barrels and poles on him. And he'd quit. I mean, he'd just take the bridle and leave, you know. I guess he was hurting somewhere, and she takes really good care of her horses, so I knew it wasn't an injection part or anything. So I sent a jug over there for a roping mare because she's a little nervous in the box. I said, try this on her. So yesterday she said, you know what? I tried it on they call him Rockstar, a little gilding. And he's back to running again. He's not silly going down the alley. She sent me a video of him. It was great. I couldn't believe it. I mean, is this unbelievable how it changed that horse's mind?
Yeah, and she said she kind of moved up in the winnings.
Yeah. She's in the stand. Oh, she's winning the buckle for the year now. But, I mean, that particular horse, that run, she like fifth out of 30 horses. But she hadn't got him through a run in a while.
Yeah.
But it's just crazy what's going on with it. And I also have a bulldogger guy that lives there, big bay horse. He's kind of hot, you know. Yesterday or day before yesterday, I said, he put him on. I said, what's it doing with that horse? He said, I got to have some more. He's a different horse now. He's mellowed down.
Yeah.
So
they settled down to focus.
It settled down in focus. I think you really, if a horse is not hurting, you know, they're going to perform so much
better.
They
want to perform,
yeah,
and, don't they?
Yeah, always. Yeah. Especially these old horses. Yeah. They still got it, just like me.
That's
you.
What they do.
You know,
yeah.
We still want to do our best, and I know they want to do their best,
but
they just can't. You know,
that's right.
But this is kind of elevate them back up to where they can do it.
Right.
I'm just.
And I think we've got somebody on the phone, Amy. Steve Lanvit.
Right. We do. Yeah, we are joined now by phone by Steve Lanvit, and hopefully get some of his comments
he's got
as
some
well,
stories
right?
to tell about the same thing.
Yeah. Hi, Steve.
Hey, Doc. How are you?
I'm good. How's Steve?
Hello. How are you guys? Very good. We're actually driving back from New York. We just finished two-day clinics out there. We're in the truck driving home.
Well, driving back from New York. Well, get back to Illinois. That's a good place to be.
You betcha.
Well, Steve, I'd like you to tell the folks a little bit about, we've just had Punk Carter talking about Equine 15 and some of the things that he's seen and what some of his people have seen with Equine 15. I think you have a couple of stories that you could relate.
Well, you know, you sent me six containers and told me to go ahead and pick out, out of the 25 horses, pick out six of them. And went through the list and gave it some thought, and I picked I've got a 13-year-old cutting horse, and it's very similar. I was listening to Puck's story, sort of very similar to that. You know, he's still doing his job, but it wasn't as fluid. And we in the past, we had to take care of his hocks. So and that's been about a year or so ago. So we put him on Element 15, and in about 10 days or so, I started to see he's coming out of his pen. He's a little bit lighter, and before you knew it, well before the end of that month of that first container, he started to act like he was back when he was 7 and 8, and he was enjoying his job. He still did his job, but, you know, after the Element 15, there was that little bit more of that youthful enthusiasm back to exactly where he was sort of playful with it, and the expression on his face, you could tell that he was sort of back to feeling his younger days.
Good.
Then we had a couple horses in for training that were, the one was a horse, you know, about 4 years old, came in for training, never thought it, my opinion, I didn't like how it moved. We went ahead and it came in barefoot. We went ahead and had it shod and changed a couple things on it. We put it on Total Equine. You know, most of the horses that come in for training are in different programs. We put them on Total Equine, and all of a sudden the horse changes. So we started doing all this. Had a lot of luck with everything we did for the first couple months, and then you sent the Element 15, put him on there, and I will tell you, again, a big difference. I don't know if it was, he was a little touchy, whether it was his knees, I could never figure it out, or his feet. We had vets look at him, and they would all say, he's not lame, there's nothing that we can see. But after the Element 15, a lot more fluid in his movement, again, enjoying his job more. Clients were happy. This is, you know, it's just going to be a family horse. They're working on their horsemanship and stuff like that. And big difference. The horse carried himself, was engaging his hind end. So they loved it. And then, you know, had another two younger mares, same situation, that were using them. I knew the one for sure. We had some joint issues. We took care of that. And that was, again, about a year ago, and I knew that we were coming due again. So instead of going ahead and taking care of it, we put him on the Element 15, and pretty much same situation. Before the end of the month, all of a sudden, we're liking our job. You know how those sometimes those mares get that little bit of that mareish attitude when they're when things aren't going
so right.
Oh, yeah,
I've heard about that.
Yeah, and all of a sudden she was pleasant and doing her job, all of them. I didn't have anything that was navicular, but you know, some soreness, and a couple horses I picked had some issues with soreness in their feet. And keeping in mind, all the horses are, you know, whether they were training horses or ours, everybody's on their total feeds, and that's always improved. But what I saw with the Element 15, the horses that I put it on, I saw a significant difference in terms of performance from before I put it on. Something noticeable. Yes, sir.
I'll tell you what, we're a little short on time here, Steve. Those are great stories, and I appreciate it very, very much. So I appreciate you calling in, and you folks drive safe, okay?
All right, Doc. We'll talk to you later, sir.
Okay, thanks.
Bye-bye. Thank you, Steve.
Bye. Thank you.
What he was saying with his older horses, almost identical to Shadow as far as getting that youth back, you might say.
That's what's so fun to hear is how we're reclaiming some of these horses that are trying to be old.
And they, you know, they want to perform, they just can't do it.
Yeah.
That's when they get nervous.
Right.
But now they're just back in action.
That's right.
It's crazy.
Well, Bunk, if you had to tell the folks why they should use Total Equine and Equine 15 in a few words, what would you say?
It works, and it's all, you know, you see results really quick. You don't have to worry about somebody feeding something wrong. You know, if I tell somebody to go out and feed my horses, I know the feed's not going to harm them in
any
way.
They can't make them sick.
Nope. You can't make them sick. That's really important.
Yes.
Because, you know, if somebody comes and feeds, and somebody comes and feeds behind them sometime, I'll fed them too much or this or that. There's no flies involved. I love that, especially in the summertime.
Okay.
No.
You think there's reduced flies in the summertime?
Oh, of course there is, because, you know.
Okay. Yeah. That's a fact, huh? That's good.
Well, I see it. I mean, I don't know why, but I'm just saying, you know, if you're
feeding sweet, I love to hear it because I've heard people say that.
If you're feeding sweet feeding stuff, you know, you're going to get flies.
Exactly.
Yeah,
but
you don't see anything like that, you know, around the Total Equine feed.
That's a real plus.
Yeah, for sure.
It is for me because we fight them all, you know.
Yeah.
It's always a problem if you've got horses or livestock. It's a problem, but I haven't seen it.
Okay.
It does help.
Well, Punk, you were talking before the show about how much you love this life that you are able to live because of horses. And so it's awesome to hear your testimony about the products that help you do all of that and keep your horses happy.
Since it came along, it's made it a lot easier for me. You know, I know what my horse is going to look like at the end of the day, you know.
Yep.
And everybody says what the blind man said when he fell to the fat horse. He said, sure is pretty, isn't he?
I like that. I'm going to remember that.
It's so true,
though. It is very true. Well, it was great to visit with you. We have to go to a break. You can check out punkcotterhorsemanship.com for more information. Of course, totalfeeds.com. Dr. Harry Anderson and I will be right back with more here on Rural America Live. Also, his phone number is 620-272-1065. If you'd like to get in touch with him, we'll be right back. Welcome back to Rural America Live with Total Feeds. I'm Amy Wilson here with Dr. Harry Anderson, the founder of Total Feeds, and we're also joined by the very beautiful and talented Penny Gilley. Great to have you here.
It's good to be here, Amy.
We will talk Total People Plus in just a second, but first we want to talk about Total Goat and an announcement about changing the kibble size, right?
I got just a couple of things about Total Goat, Amy. We've gotten some feedback from people that say their little goats and little lambs don't like to eat the bigger kibble.
Okay.
So what we did, we have started making it in the smaller kibble so that the little goats and the little lambs can eat it better, because that's just like the one we make in the deer feed. You know, the deer have little mouths, so we make the smaller kibble. You can see it's about a third the size of the regular kibble that the horses eat. So that's kind of an important thing. And then the total goat, we have a really good thing going with the total goat. We have a lot of different things happening with it. I'd like to show a few of the comments and results on the screen. Here's the bag. People will see this bag, and we're going to announce a little later about Chewy, and they'll be able to see it there too. But as far as the results we typically get, here's what people tell us. They tell us about improved fertility, improved milk production, better muscling in the show goats, and better hair coats. Now, I didn't know that a hair coat was that important on a goat, but they say it is. And reduced parasite load. I'm not saying you don't worm goats on when they're on this, but it gives some assistance to the worming programs and they get a little better. So that's one thing. And then, you know, we're going to talk about the Canine 15. And that's something new that goes along with the Equine 15 that we've talked about earlier. We're not going to talk a lot about it here, but it's a very similar, it's the same product in a form for a dog. It comes in little tiny capsules, and they just take capsules, and very simple to administer. Dogs seem to like it, but we're seeing some real good benefits of it. It literally controls different viruses. And I think that's very important. And it does this in all kinds of species, not just the dog. You feed it in the capsule form in their food, and it's available over the counter. So anybody can buy it. You don't have to have a prescription for it. It's not a drug. It's not a medication. But it kind of acts like one from what they've been able to tell. But I just wanted to show one pair of dogs that are on this, and that's Donnie and Jean Gang in Oklahoma have these two rescue Pyrenees guard dogs. And these dogs were not getting around well, even though they were on Total Canine, you know, and they should have been doing fine, but they would just need a little help. And so they put them on Canine 15, voila, just like Punk was saying earlier, these older dogs, just like the older horses, they all of a sudden their joints loosen up and they move around free and easy. So we're pretty proud of that.
Yeah, experiencing a lot of the benefits that you're talking about with the Canine 15. So
you
great
bet.
Information there. Let's talk about Total Canine.
Total Canine is one of my favorite topics, and that's another one that's getting very popular. But the Total Canine is very interesting, and some of the things, it's not just a good basic dog food. We hear that a lot, how people say that their dogs don't eat as much of it, so it's a lot more efficient. And it has all of the bells and whistles, the chelated trace minerals, the ascorbate, the dosim that we always talk about in our other products. But something that I've been hearing a little bit of, and that is I have customers telling me they just do not worm their dogs anymore and they have no worm problems whatsoever. Now, I'm not saying you to quit worming your dogs just like, you know, the goats or anything else, but if it can assist the current programs, and some people just aren't having the problems. And also tick and flea comments. You know, we've had a lot of comments over the time about tick and flea problems not existing in deer that eat our total deer. I don't know why, but there's something in here that's getting through the skin that's keeping those ticks and fleas from coming on. Well, some of the dog people are telling me the same thing. They don't have to use as much or if any tick and flea programs on their dogs. And that's a nuisance, if you will, and a real nuisance to the dog itself because it's such an irritant. But I've got somebody on the phone, I think, that hi, Claire, are you there?
Yes, I'm here.
Well, hi, Claire. How are things in El Dorado, Texas?
Oh, it's good, Doc. Really good. We got a little rain, and it's just wonderful.
Great. Well, Claire, I'd like you to tell the folks, relate one story about your dogs, your female dog. Again, we're dealing with a guard dog that's very, very critical to livestock operations. Tell us about the dog.
Well, she's and she's already had one set of puppies, and her first set of puppies, of course, I give my guard dogs all a free choice food, and when she had those puppies, she just fell apart. She had no energy. She was just skin and bones. The puppies looked pretty good, but I really thought for a while she might just die on us. I mean, she just felt terrible. Her gums were white.
Eating total equine, right? I mean, total canine?
No, this was on just regular dog food. We won't say what kind. But the second set of puppies, I put her on total canine. And she never missed a beat. She looks great. She didn't lose her condition. She feeds her puppies and then she's gone. Like I've got work to do, pup.
She'd go out and go to work, right?
She goes right back to work, comes back, feeds her puppies, and she's gone again. She's a busy dog. Feels great. Looks great. Puppies look great. Like it's just amazing.
Well, we've got the picture up here on the screen, and they look rather healthy. In fact, they look a little plump, like if they weren't hanging on there, they'd probably just roll over.
They're as wide as they are tall. They're so fat. Yes.
I love it.
And she just feels so good. Yeah. Like, I'm not kidding. I really thought I might lose her with that first set of puppies.
Yeah, and Claire, oh, that's great. I appreciate that. And you know, and there's another product that you've been using quite a bit, and that's something that that you and Penny Gilley have in common here. That Penny's on the stage with us. You probably can't see that. I know you can't see that, but Penny can hear you. Tell us a little bit about your experience with Total People Plus.
Well, it is just amazing. I take four pills a day. I take two in the morning and two about mid-afternoon. And I always know when I haven't taken it because I'm so lethargic. I'm just kind of like, I've got to do something. I just want to sit down. And so I'm thinking, I haven't taken my Total People. I go take it. I have a burst of energy. I'm ready to go, clear-minded again, and my hair is growing like crazy. I'm getting new hair. My eyelashes are thick and long, and it's just the best thing since sliced bread, I'm telling you. It's awesome.
Well, that is great. And just if you just hang on the line a minute, now, Penny, you maybe have a comment. Does any of your stuff go along with what Claire's talking about?
Absolutely, Claire. I can relate. I just recently had to cut 3 inches off of my hair this past week because it just grows like crazy. Yeah, it's good.
It does. And I mean, like, I'm nearly 60 years old. Like, I've done menopause, the whole nine yards, and these vitamins are better than any drug anybody could come up with. Like, as far as your just how good you feel and how much energy you have.
Absolutely.
Well, that's great. I wanted the two of you on the same time, Penny, because I heard so many things that you guys have in common, and you're not that far apart in age, and a lot of the things you guys talk about, I think a lot of people could use.
Oh, absolutely. You know, just not only for the well-being, your whole well-being, Total People Plus is phenomenal. And I tell people today, and there's so much chaos going on right now in the country and stuff, but with everything going on, Total People Plus is amazing for boosting the immune system. So, yeah.
Well, Claire, do you have any other comments about anybody else that you've started on Total People Plus?
Oh yes. Like, when my hairdresser saw my hair, she's like, I need some of this. Get me some of this. And she's on it, and she's having the same. She's younger than me, like, quite a bit. But it worked. She put her husband on it. Like, nobody I've told about that's using it, says Claire, I just don't get it. Nobody. Like, my sister's on it. I was like, lapping her in the work pen, okay? Like, she's going, I'm dying. And I'm like, if you don't get on these stuff, you know, and now she's on it, she can keep right up with me. We're going.
Keeping on, Claire.
I sound like I'm just happy as heck, but I just feel good.
That's good. That's the important thing, feeling good. Well, Claire, I appreciate it. We have to go on to another topic, but I appreciate you very much. And another time, I want you to tell about your horse and Equine 15, but we'll leave that for another time. Thank you.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you, Doc.
A big thank you to Claire for joining us.
That's awesome.
That's great. And, you know, she covered a lot of the things about the things that we see with Total People Plus. And I always stress the thing that you probably hear that too, Penny, is about blood pressure, type 2, the blood sugar being more controllable.
Absolutely.
Cholesterol being more stable and lower. Are those real things that you hear all the time?
Hear all the time. And I talk to so many diabetics that take it, love it, their blood levels, all that stuff, it just controls. And when they do have that little bottom out, you know, that fatigue, the Total People kicks in and they just say, you know, I can keep going. I mean, people have been on it now for years. I talk to them all the time. They're still loving it. Mm-hmm. And, you know, whether you're just needing, you know, a boost with your hair, skin, nails, whatever, or your immune system, or whatever, the joints, it's just a phenomenal product. And I tell people all the time, those trace minerals, they kick those vitamins into gear. And that, it happens. And, yeah.
And one thing I don't really hear much part, and I don't know if I've heard you talking about it, but just the skin texture, the quality of skin. You know, we talk about hair coats and the skin in horses and dogs. What about people? You ever hear anything like that?
Oh, yeah. I've had a good conversation with a girl that was 17 years old that had psoriasis, really, really bad. She got on the Total People Plus, and it's been controllable, and she's been doing a lot better. I've talked to other people that have had skin problems, and they're doing better. So, yeah, I mean, it's really a great product for the skin and for the eczema and things like that.
Yeah, well, psoriasis, I see these ads on TV and they talk about all this medication you can, or this chemicals you can take, and they say, at the bottom they'll say, many people see results in 90 to 100 days.
Mm. Wow.
How long does it take to see it with nutrition from the inside? Not very long, right?
Not very long.
No, not even not close long. To that.
Speaking of not very long, I've got a great testimonial, too, coming
yes.
up.
Yes. Well, I want to hear that. This is one that's very new, and I wanted you to be here today to talk about this directly because it's one that I think is affecting so many people. So tell us about your...
Well, I got a phone call from this lady, and she was just beyond her... I mean, she was ecstatic. Her name is Thelma Middleton, and she's from Lamar, Colorado. And she said that her whole life, beginning as a young child, 5 or 6 years old, she called it first. She said it was a ticking in her ear,
yeah,
and a ring, and she could not get over it. And she went to doctors. They were unable to diagnose or solve the issues. And this has been going on for 50 years. She said, I've just had to deal with it my whole life, Penny. She said, I got on Total People Plus, and in a short while, the ringing is almost gone, virtually gone. She said it's hard for her to believe that she's finally gotten relief after all these years. What a wonderful product, she said.
Tinnitus or ringing in the ears typically is something that they cannot correct. I have it. I've had it. Used to have it a lot. I don't know if I have it as much now. I haven't thought about it because you get used to it.
Well, that's what
but
she said.
It's a very annoying
issue. She said she went to tons of doctors through the years. No one could put their finger on it and just say, okay, this can be fixed.
Yeah.
They could not really diagnose, you know, whether tendonitis, this or this or this.
Yeah. That's great. Well, folks, we're not making any promises, but you heard just what this lady said, and she's a real live lady, and she'd bear for it, right?
Oh, yeah. I've got an old drummer friend of mine. I'm going to tell him he really needs to try it because he's had the ringing and the tendonitis in his ears for quite a while. So who knows, you know?
Yeah.
It's worth a try.
Anything that I missed as far as why people should take this?
Well, boost the immune system, which is very, very important in the times we're living in. We all, when we go out, we want to be at our best. So I tell folks, take care of yourself, do the best you can, and what better way than to do it natural?
There you go.
Natural, 100% all natural, folks.
I agree.
Yeah.
Great. Well, Penny, thank you so much for joining us. It's been great to have
you. Amy, it's always great to see you and to be here with Dr. Anderson, and just thank everybody out there for watching and tuning in.
Of course, you can find more information about Total People Plus on TotalFeeds.com. We also want to give out Dr. Harry Anderson's number again. It's a cell phone number, 620-272-1060. Welcome back to Rural America Live with Total Feeds. I'm Amy Wilson, joined by the founder, Dr. Harry Anderson. As we talk about Total Feeds, you can check it out, totalfeeds.com. Also, Dr. Harry Anderson's cell phone number, 620-272-1065. If you would like to contact him with questions or a testimony. And we have another special guest. This is Dave Wolf, the president of the Ranch Sorting National Championships. So we'll have a lot of details about that coming up. But first, we have a special announcement for everyone.
Yes, Amy, we can announce this now. We've been at it for a couple of months, and it's looking like it's going to work. We're going to have 4 products available on Chewy. You can order it and have it dropped in your mailbox. Well, not your mailbox, but close to there. But we're going to have Total Equine, RLNSC, Total Goat, and Total Canine, all available. And people are already buying it, and it's starting to move along well through that system, which I was skeptical of, but they wanted to have it. So it's working, and kind of exciting to see a new marketing method that we weren't a part of before. So check that out. Go to Chewy.com, and you can find them right on there.
Yeah, congratulations. That's awesome. Yeah. So as we talk about the Ranch Sorting National Championships, you are involved in a lot of great events and associations, but we want to talk to Dave about what this is all about and their upcoming event.
Well, we've been associated a while now. How long have we been together, Dave?
I think 2010, so this is our 10th anniversary right here.
10th anniversary. I remember the day we met.
I do too.
Oklahoma City.
Holy
cow.
Absolutely.
That was a scary day because you guys wanted some help.
Need a little help, Doc.
I was just a new kid out there. I didn't know what was going on for what you guys wanted, but I'm glad I kind of jumped in the water.
You know, it worked. It really worked. And we're thrilled to have you on board for these years. And you've seen us grow, and we've seen you grow. And I think it's worked great for both of us. And that's what it's all about.
You know, Dave, one of the things that a lot of people watching may not even know what ranch sorting is. We've got a little video here. Would you like to tell the people kind of what's involved with ranch sorting? And they're going to show the kind of where the finals are going to be here in about a week. So if we could see that video.
You bet. Well, I'll be happy to, Doc. You know, the sport is all about sorting cows from calves and steers from heifers, just exactly like what's done on the ranch for hundreds of years. We brought that talent to town and made a sport out of it, just like a lot of the rodeo events are now. That's what they are, is a talent that's brought to town and made a sport out of it. It's done in a figure eight round pen about 50 foot across. The cattle are numbered 0 through 9 with one blank cow. It's a two-person team. They go in that pen. They're given a number. Let's say they're given number 3, or for this example, number 1. They sort that number 1 out of the herd and send him to the other side. Then they get the 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0 in order. If they go across out of order, it's no time. They have a 1-minute time limit to do it.
Okay.
The most cattle sorted and the fastest amount of time wins the game. That's what it's about.
I know I've watched a lot of them, and it looks like a lot of fun. They get a little excited once in a while, don't they?
Oh, certainly they do. That's what competition does. It gets the adrenaline up, and everybody gets to going and going fast. But this sport has evolved so much, Doc. We started in 2007.
Yeah.
And, we have our finals right here in Fort Worth. It's coming up next week.
Right.
The 7th through the 13th of June, we're going to give away $600,000 in cash and prizes. Yep. We'll have 6,000 teams here from all across the United States. And we're especially excited about it this year because we're the first national event back on board. It's been a rough 3 months for all of us.
Right.
But we're excited to be right here at Fort Worth and kicking it off in a great fashion.
Well, yeah, and that's great. I'm looking forward to it. Let's go back a little bit about how you've grown. Since I met you, I forget how many members you had. I think it was like 10 or 11,000.
Less than that.
Yeah.
We met, we had 5,000.
5,000.
5,000 members in our association.
That was 10 years ago.
Yes, sir.
How many do you have today?
28,000.
28,000, if my math is pretty good, that's 23,000. Well, that's pretty good growth per year.
Yeah.
Percentage-wise, that's a pretty good growth per year.
Yeah, this sport has
Where all the sorting take place?
East Coast and West Coast, all across the United States. We have 400 sanctioned events a year across the United States, which is a lot. If you're looking to get involved in the sport, there's a place to go pretty near you. We also are in Australia, Brazil, Canada, a lot of different countries too.
What's the age limit on this?
Young or old, either one. How's that?
Have you had them? Sorry.
We really have had 3 or 4 year old kids get out there, and you know, mom and dad has that perfect little horse for them that just camps them out, and they trot around in that pen, and they learn how to read a cow. And that's really what it's all about. It's a finesse game about learning how to understand what a cow's going to do before he does it.
Sure.
And it's a great training ground for horsemen of all levels.
How old have you seen them sort?
So we've had 85-year-olds out there sorting. We have a master's, a legends class is what we call them. 65 and over.
Legends, that means you're old?
You're a legend. You're special. How's that?
Well, I just wanted to make sure I understood that. So what's going to happen next week in Fort Worth? What all is going to take place at the finals?
Right here at the John Justin Arena, Will Rogers Memorial Center, we will have 7 sorting pens set up at one time.
Okay.
And all of those pens will be going at once. Each day, we're probably going to run 1,200 to 1,300 teams. First go teams, not counting second, third, and fourth go teams. But the contestants have qualified throughout the year. However, this year it's open. Because of the COVID-19, we opened it up. Anybody that wants to come to our finals can come and compete this year. You didn't have to qualify. If you're a beginner and have never sorted, we have a place for you here at our finals.
Okay.
But we're going to give out a lot of prizes, a lot of cash, a lot of money, and people are going to have a lot of fun.
Okay, and we're as Total Feeds, we're delighted to be involved with that project in a way so that people can enjoy it at home. There's going to be a camera above every sorting pen all day long, every day, so they can watch any person they choose, how will they know when to watch if they have some buddies sorting and they're in Kentucky or California or something? How are they going to know when to watch that buddy sort?
So it's going to be live stream. Thanks to Total Feeds. We really appreciate you guys coming on board and being a part of that. You can go to ranchsorting.com, check it out. If you haven't ever seen the sport of ranch sorting, you're going to be able to learn all the ins and outs in this 1 week.
There you go. That's a good place to learn, folks, if you want to see how it's done.
You bet. So the opportunity is there, and we welcome everybody to get involved with it and come check it out. I think it's going to be a great event for us.
Yeah, great.
Yeah, exciting to see events taking place again and that you opened it up to everyone. I'm sure you're expecting big numbers.
We certainly are. In fact, you know, we don't take pre-entries. However, this year we are because of the COVID-19, but typically we don't, but we monitor the stall reservations. Mm-hmm. And this is our largest year of stall reservations. So people are dying to get back out. I know, Amy, back in March, that was, I think, our last event before the big shutdown. We were supposed to be at Houston and it got canceled. Right. So mm-hmm. we came up to Glen Rose and Amy snuck down there and played with us a little bit. It was a lot of fun, but that was the last time any of us were out.
Yeah.
And to be able to kick this event off, it'll be the first major national equine event in America back on board. And we're going to be right here in Fort Worth doing it. I'm proud of that. I'm very proud of it.
Good. Well, Dave, I can't let you go unless I hear a little bit about why do you use Total Equine?
Well, Doc, I tell you, I wish we had a couple hours. Truly, I'm fortunate. I have a wonderful wife and three wonderful boys, and all three of the boys have grown up in the equine industry, and now they're trainers on their own in the equine industry, and they all feed their horses Total Equine.
Good.
And you know, it was sort of when we first started, it was sort of my secret. My horses were fit and looked good and slick, and he sort of elbowed me and he said, "Hey,
you know, let people know.
Let the secret out a little bit."
Yeah.
But you know, I've had the wonderful opportunity of judging horses all around the world. I was a quarter horse judge and did it for a long time, and I know a fit horse when I see a fit horse, and I know a horse that's blooming and looking good. And that's what Total Equine does.
Great.
It makes them slick. You know, it just makes a finish to them. They have the energy level, but they're not hyper. They're not all pumped up on sugar.
There you go.
These horses do great on Total Equine. And our memberships know it, too. They okay. All across the United States.
Good. I'm glad you're letting the secret out. Well, thanks a lot for sharing all this with us. I think they're going to appreciate if they'll just go and watch some of that.
Yeah, it is. I was impressed. I think you were running three pins when I was there.
Yeah,
it happens fast, and there's a lot going on, and it's a fun thing to be a part of. You could tell everyone really enjoys it.
Yeah. We enjoyed you coming, too.
Well, thanks. It was fun to be there with all of you. Before we have to let you go, talk about the importance of Total Feeds for the ranch sorting program.
So obviously, as one of our leading sponsors, when I first started RSNC Ranch Sorting National Championships, you know, I went to sponsors and I just wanted those famous sponsors on board. Mm-hmm. You know, and when I met up with Doc, I said, "This is a perfect opportunity for us to grow together and get big." And look at it now. I mean, the premier equine feed in America. Mm-hmm. And here we have them on board with us. So I'm proud of it. I really am proud of it. And I appreciate you, Doc, for all you've done with our sport to help us grow.
I appreciate hearing that.
Yeah, it's a great partnership. Of course, we've been talking to Dave Wolf. He's the president of the Ranch Sorting National Championships coming up right here in Fort Worth, Texas. Dr. Anderson, we want to show everyone a video called Rodeo Wisdom. Do you want to introduce this?
Rodeo Wisdom is something that Corey has devised with, and they're putting together little clips of people that have been in the rodeo talking about rodeo.
All right, let's take a look at that now.
You know, we got the chance to, you know, I got to do those clinics with you. And, you know, that was kind of funny because I would get there and this would be a Charmaine James barrel racing clinic. And, And she would introduce me, and those girls were like, we didn't come to ride with this guy. And Charmaine goes, no, you need to go with him, and he can show you some stuff that's going to help you be a better rider. And it worked.
I just think it was a great combination to get those horsemanship skills in there. And it's only going to make you be able to take care of your horse better, to feel what your horse is doing, know him, just knowing him better, and riding better, being aware of everything that's going on. Well, it's just a, you know, in a different perspective.
Absolutely. I think if you know, one of the things I always say is I go out to the pen, I go out to the corral, as I perform at a expo or a clinic, I always say I'm there as a student, you know, because I'm there to learn, to get better, to learn from people, learn from the horse, learn from the situation and circumstances, and just like you were saying, continue to grow and get better.
Sure, and just like as a teacher, you're constantly, look, if something isn't working, I'm not blaming them or blaming the horse. What do I got to do? What do I have to do to change it up and think outside the box?
That was Rodeo Wisdom with Craig Cameron and Charmaine James, and those are available on your YouTube channel and also on social media. And as you mentioned, Corey doing the Rodeo Wisdom videos, that's your son Corey, a big part of your program too.
Yes, he does all of our video work and those kinds of things, so when you see a video, he and Ben have had something to do with it.
Yeah, be sure and check out their YouTube channel, all of their social media, and you can check out totalfeeds.com for all the information about all their products. And Dr. Harry gives out his cell phone number if you'd like to contact him directly at 620-272-1065. Well, we've been talking a lot about the Ranch Sorting National Championships, the 7th through the 13th, right here in Fort Worth, Texas. We're looking forward to that. There's another event coming up that you're involved in.
Yes, coming up soon, the BFI, Bob Feist International Invitational, and that's going to be taking place in Oklahoma this year.
Right.
For the first time. That's quite a big change. We will probably not be present there a lot personally, but there again, we're going to have a lot of signage, and we're going to be a part of anybody that's live streaming that we work with will be a part of the live streaming program. And then in early July, we'll be at the Little Britches Finals in Guthrie, Oklahoma, at the Lazy E. So we're going to be at two big events at the Lazy E in about a two-week period. And so we're pretty excited about that. But that's about the most that we're going to be doing until early September. But then once September 1 gets here, it's going to get wild.
That's good. We're all looking forward to that.
We'll be back first week of August to talk about that.
Yeah, we look forward to that as well. Well, we talked a lot on today's show about some new and exciting things, a new kibble size on the Total Goat and Total Lamb. You also talked about how some of your products are available at Chewy.com. We're down to just a few seconds. Any final comment?
Well, just please let us know if we can do anything for you. I try to make sure I get all the calls answered, all the texts answered, all of the emails answered. Takes a little time.
You stay very busy.
We're going to work at it. And we're adding new dealers every day. So keep checking the dealer finder, because I get probably two or three opportunities for dealers every day.
That's great. You can check out all that information, totalfeeds.com. We appreciate you watching Rural America Live on RFD TV. I'm Amy Wilson for Dr. Harry Anderson and Total Feeds. Have a great night.